Hey guys, it's time for more apportionment in Excel. This time, we're going to focus on Jefferson's method. Let's go back through the basics before we actually jump into Jefferson's method. To start every problem, you need a total population. So you take your individual state populations and you sum them up, as we have done before, to find your total population. Then we can put that total population in here just to make sure we've got it in a place we know what it is. To find a standard divisor, which we should know how to do, but as a reminder, you take your total population and you divide it by the number of seats in this case. Now we have our standard divisor. Standard divisors are used to find standard quotas. The naming matches. Let's do a little highlighting to also kind of make it match up so that it's easy to remember that standard divisor goes with standard quota. To do a standard quota, you always take the state's individual population and divide it by that standard divisor. But remember, when we drag this formula down, we don't want that standard divisor to move down, so we need to anchor it. So I will hit the F4 button so that it puts in the dollar signs to anchor that cell so it won't change when I copy the formula. So I hit enter. Now I can see that standard quota. I'm going to take that and drag it down to each state. So now I have the standard quotas for each state. But Jefferson's method doesn't use the standard quotas. It uses modified quotas, and modified quotas come from a modified divisor. Jefferson's method looks for a divisor that has to be less than the standard divisor, which will give us modified quotas that, when they are rounded down, always add up to the correct number of seats. So this modified divisor is something you're basically going to be guessing. And for Jefferson's method, like I said, it needs to be smaller than the standard divisor. So I'm just going to guess 750 to get us started. Now, modified divisor will always go with the modified quotas. So again, color coding to help us remember. But you find it the exact same way as a standard quota. You hit equals, you take the individual state population, and you divide it by that modified divisor. And because we're going to be dragging the formula down and we don't want that number to change, again, we need to anchor that modified divisor. So we can hit enter, and now we have a modified quota for this state. But we need to drag that formula down and get modified quotas for all of the states. Now, Jefferson's method always rounds down. So again, we're going to hit equals and type round down. When you open the parentheses, it first wants to know what do you want to round down. I want to round down this cell, which is D7, hit a comma, and then how many places? I want 0 decimal places, so put in a 0 and close the parentheses. And it will now round that down. I need to take that formula and copy it to every state. So with a modified divisor of 750, here is the apportionment. We need to check if that used all 30 seats. So hit equals and let's sum this apportionment, close those parentheses, and hit enter. I did not. Right now, I've only used 29 seats. So this is not the modified divisor I want to use. Now, the beautiful thing about Excel is that since we used cell references for each of these formulas we type in, if I just change this modified divisor, all of the rest of my work will automatically change. So if 750 didn't work, let's try something else. Remember, we have to stay lower than our standard divisor, so I'm going to guess something lower. How about 730? Now, when I hit enter, these changed, but they didn't change enough. So these all stayed the same. So 730 still didn't work. How about 710? Again, the modified quota's changed, but not enough to change these, so I guess I need to go even lower. How about 700? That did it. There it is. When I went to 700, these changed enough that it changed one number over here and gave me the correct number of seats that I needed. So it looks like I needed a modified divisor of 700. Just so you are aware, you could have used other numbers close to 700 that would have worked out the same. In fact, I think if you try 690, it also works out correctly. So there's not one perfect answer for the modified divisor, but that is the method that's Jefferson's method. I hope that helps you. Thanks, and look for the other videos for Webster's method and Hill-Huntington.